Hey guys, my name's Simon Hayter, and today we're going to be looking at the simple task of moving and rotating objects in Cinema 4D. So as you can see on the screen here, I've got Cinema 4D already loaded up. So all I'm going to do is add a sphere or a ball. I'm going to put it over there because we're going to have lots going on. So I've added the ball, and basically we'll start off by learning how to rotate an object, which is really straightforward. As you're down here, you've got a time frame. So the animation is 90 frames at the moment. So let's increase that to, say, let's make it 120. So as you can see down here, we've now got 120 frames to play with versus the 90 we had before. So let's go ahead and rotate this object. So as you can see, I'm on keyframe 0. I'm going to add a keyframe here, which is basically starting off the record, and it's added it down here, which is a little blue block. So I'm going to take it all the way up to 120 frames. I'm then going to tell, you can do this manually by doing getting that up and rotating it if you want to do that, but I like to work in exact measurements or rotations degrees. So let's add 360 here, click apply, and then we're going to end the keyframe or add the keyframe, and hopefully the object should turn when I move here. Yes, it does. So basically what Cinema 4D has done, it said between 0 and 120 frames I must rotate this object 360 degrees. So give or take, well, 120 frames, so every frame will be rotating the ball exactly 3 degrees. So, you know, 3 times 120 is 360 degrees. So there's that. So let's make it a bit more complicated now. Let's add a square. Let's make that smaller just for this video. So we've got a tiny little square there, and basically what we want to do is rotate that as well. So as you notice down here, we've no longer got any keyframes. This is because it works independently. You can do it to a group or you can do it to an object. So in this case the sphere's got it, but the cube hasn't got it yet. So if I click play, the ball turns. It's very hard to see. I actually did make a material to make it a bit easier to see that without having it click. So if I click play, you can see that's rotating and the cube's doing nothing. So let's get that cube doing something. So we click the cube, and basically what I'm going to do is, you can start the recording process in any frame. So if you wanted to start it at 30 frames, if you're doing an intro and you want, you know, your logo to come on the screen, or you know, you want it to be a blank screen for 5 seconds before your logo comes in, then you would start your logo at a higher keyframe, meaning you don't have to do any extra editing in any other software like Sony Vegas or anything like that. So let's get it rotating at 30. So I've got my cube, I've got it on 30 frame. I'm going to introduce a keyframe, and I'm going to say, take it all the way up to 120, but this time I'm going to put the rotation in the middle. So what that does is it will rotate it differently than what we had before. So I've rotated that, I'm going to put the keyframe, and hopefully that starts to rotate clockwise. So as you can see, the ball rotates as well. But as you noticed, when we get there, it stops. So if I go down to 0 and I push play, we've got our sphere moving and then our cube moves afterwards. So let's stop that, give that a nice little blue. So let's add another object now, because I did say that we'll be looking at moving objects. So let's make this 75 and 15, doesn't matter, and 70, that will do. So let's move that here, and we basically want to get this object moving. So let's pull it up here. So keyframe 0, So add a keyframe. And let's go all the way to keyframe 20. But let's move this down to here and end the keyframe. So what should happen is it should start going up and down. And there we go. And that basically ends our tutorial. It's very simple, but I hope it helps someone. Thanks very much. Bye-bye.